I remember Gartner made this comment that the year 2024 was all about accessing knowledge. And that's where the more kind of the first generation of generative AI use cases that we saw was a lot more about accessing knowledge. And then 2025 was the year about action on that knowledge. And you know, when we hear action on that knowledge, that talks about agentic AI, which is really the big transformation that we're seeing right now with a lot of our customers. The reality here is that the vision for generative AI is very exciting for our customers, but at the same time, what we're learning is that there's a lot of work that needs to be done. And you know, while our customers are very excited to experiment and to build using generative AI, what we've learned with our work with Gartner as well, there's a lot of work around preparing your data estate and data readiness. A lot of these generative AI projects that our customers build or plan on either end up costing significantly more than was budgeted for, or often don't even make it to production. And that is because the data estate or the data readiness is not actually there. So what we're learning really is just so important for us to understand our customers, where they are in their data strategy, understand how AI decisions are being made, understand the role of technology leaders within their organization. You know, not only is this important, is it important that we help our customers and really help them understand that vision, but we also need to make sure that we're helping them deliver on these projects successfully. What we're learning about the world of generative AI and AI projects in general, but particularly with Agentic, is the role of the business leader who's responsible for helping define use cases and making the investment decisions in these AI solutions. You know, a lot of these decisions are even made without IT even being involved. And that really is a new audience for us to really focus on in a lot of our go-to-market. I remember back in early 2023, you know, really opening up to our customers that all of us are first movers here and we're all figuring this out together. You know, I think agentic AI, you know, the new wave of agentic AI is a fascinating new opportunity, but we're back to the start here again around really understanding what use cases are the ones that are going to have the greatest impact for our customers that use agentic AI. And agentic is very complex. You know, we're really redefining the world of modern applications and the way that we interact with technology, but also the way they're automating a lot of business process. And that presents a really good opportunity for our customers to do a lot more, a lot faster, and hopefully at a lower cost. But, of course, that means that there's a lot of things that our customers need to consider. And those are the things that we talked about before around data governance, security, the cost of building out these solutions, all of these things that need to happen before doing that. So, you know, when we're thinking about our go-to-market, we need to take all of these different parts into consideration as we're thinking about how to engage our customers. Now, the reality here, and this is one of the conversations I've really enjoyed in my discussion with Gartner, again, is when we talk about the technology adoption maturity model that Gartner had built out. And we really use that when we're thinking about how to engage our different sets of customers in a very different way. Spent a lot of time in inquiries with a lot of the analysts to build my own understanding of our markets across Asia, buying patterns, the vision around agentic AI, AI go-to-market strategy, and so on. And I think a lot of that was very helpful. I mean, it helped me with my own working knowledge. And this is the kind of the day-to-day conversation that I might have with our leaders or with my team or with my stakeholders. This also helps with my speed of making decisions, which turns out to be quite important. It helps to build my own credibility in front of, again, the organization and leaders at Microsoft, but also my profile as a market expert, which of course is a very important competence of a go-to-market leader. It also helps us validate a lot of our go-to-market programs that we've defined as well, really having Gartner kind of validating a lot of the ideas and the decisions that we've made. We're using more of the benefits around documents and plan reviews. As we're going into our financial year planning, we're working closely with Gartner using their workshop capability to help guide and inform a lot of our plans as well. As far as the return back to the business, here's how I like to think about it. You know, number one, like what are the impactful decisions that I made? And what was the speed that I was able to make those decisions? And with what quality? Because of my relationship with Gartner. Right? And you know, if I think back over the last several months of some of the initiatives or the priorities that we've delivered across Asia, I can think of several instances where I've made a more informed decision that was able to influence our leaders more effectively that ended up having a very material impact on our ability to execute as an organization. So the question I would ask myself instead is, if I didn't have the relationship with Gartner, would I have made the same decision at the same speed?